हेलो एवरीवन, अ वेरी वॉर्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू स्वा एजुकेशन. माई सेल्फ राधा, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ फूड एंड न्यूट्रिशनल वैल्यू ऑफ फूड. सो दिस इज अ टॉपिक फ्रॉम फूड प्रोसेसिंग टेक्नोलॉजी यूनिट ऑफ पेपर 2 ऑफ तेलंगाना फूड सेफ्टी ऑफिसर सिलेबस. एंड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट रिलेटेड टू फूड, लाइक फूड प्रोसेसिंग, फूड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, basic structure of food, and today we are going to discuss composition and nutritional values. So today we are going to target this portion. So basic introduction of food is that food can be derived from plant like vegetables and fruits, carcass of animals and single cell organism. And the food mainly consists of water, carbohydrate, protein, lipid and mineral. In one line, what we can say that food consists of macro as well as micronutrient, and these nutrients are required for proper functioning of our body. A host of other compounds present in minor quantity like vitamin, color and flavor compound, functional additive. These are present in food, but they present in minor quantity. But macronutrient or micronutrient, that are water, carbohydrate, protein, lipid and mineral, macronutrient, these are present in larger quantity. And these have a significant impact on the quality of many product. So food component or food material that present in the food are like carbohydrate, protein, vitamin, fat, calcium, iodine, phosphorus, sodium, iron, water, fiber. So carbohydrate, this is an example of macronutrient as we have discussed in previous lecture, and these are digested and then broken down into glucose and provide energy to the body. So carbohydrate are a main source of energy, and by taking that energy our body is able to do some functional work or day-to-day life activities. Second one is the protein. Protein is also macronutrient in nature and it helps in metabolism. Metabolism like catabolism and anabolism. And protein acts as an enzyme. So mainly we know that enzyme acts as a protein. Enzyme are proteinaceous in nature. So what we can also say that protein also acts as an enzyme. And hormones are also proteinaceous in nature, so protein can act as an hormone also. Next one is the vitamin. These help in maintaining healthy bone. Healthy bone, for vitamin D is responsible for that, heel wounding, vitamin K, repair and damage of cell and boost the immune system and converting food into enzyme or energy. And vitamin, these are micronutrient. Next one is the fat. It store energy, protect and insulate the important organ. Next one is the calcium. It help in the proper functioning of nervous system and maintain healthy bones. Next one is iodine. It is the reason for the formation of thyroid hormone. Next one is phosphorus. It help to maintain acid-base balance in the body. Next one is sodium. It controls the blood pressure as well as it also maintain electrical gradient inside the cell, because sodium potassium pump in which two potassium efflux outside the cell and three sodium influx inside the cell. Control the blood pressure. Next one is the iron. It facilitates the formation of hemoglobin. So if there is a deficiency of iron in the body of any person, that person can suffer from anemia. If there is a deficiency of iron, person can suffer from anemia. Next one is water. They help in absorbing nutrient from food and release waste from the body in the form of urine and sweat and keep our body in hydrated condition. Next one is the fiber. They help in food absorption and prevent constipation. So this is a very important chart according to your exam point of view. Type of food component supplied by food. The main food components supply the human body. First one is they are necessary for body building. So body building material, energy yielding material, element and compound indispensable for metabolism. So what is it? So first one is body building material. Polysaccharide. Protein and lipids serve as the building material of different structure of the plant and animal tissue used for food. So in previous lecture we discussed that carbohydrate can be formed in simple or complex condition. In simpler form it can be monosaccharide, in complex form it can be polysaccharide. So polysaccharide, protein building block of amino acid, and lipid serve as the building material of different structure of plant and animal tissue used for food. Next one is the structure made of these material like polysaccharide, protein and lipid are responsible for the form and tensile strength of the tissue and created the necessary condition for metabolic process to occur. Compartmentalization result from this structure play a crucial biological role in the organism. Some of the main component as well as other constituent are bound to different cell structure. Like when we are discussing about cell structure, so all we know that cell is made up of carbohydrate, protein and lipid, in which protein and lipid are present in more amount and carbohydrate present in integrated condition. When carbohydrate integrated with protein, it is called proteoglycan. When it integrated with lipid, it is called glycolipid or glycocalyx. So, some of the main component as well as other constituent are bound to cell structure or are distributed in soluble form in the tissue fluid. So, these material are mainly responsible for bodybuilding. Next one is the energy yielding material. So carbohydrate is the main source of energy and the cheapest source of food, can be readily digested, absorbed and utilized for producing energy, and the most efficient source of energy. So the main point related to carbohydrate, it is a rich source of energy and entirely derived from vegetable source. Main source, starch in granular form in the cereal, pulses and tuber and sugar that are present in milk, fruit and vegetable and sucrose. Next one is protein. Oxidation of carbon skeleton of amino acid of protein furnish a minor but significant fraction of the daily energy requirement. So it is also, we can say, a kind of source of energy. Next one is the fat, that is triglyceride. Means backbone is composed of glycerol moiety from plant and animal source, rank close behind carbohydrate as main source of energy. Fat has a high fuel value. It has got a high capacity to be stored as energy in the body. And there is a little difference between animal and vegetable fat as a source of energy. So what we have discussed, type of food component supplied by the food. The main components supply the human body are bodybuilding material. We discussed what are bodybuilding material that present in our food. Second one is energy yielding material that we discussed. And third one is element and compound indispensable for metabolism. Next one is the function of food. The main food components supply the human body with the necessary building material and source of energy as well as element and compound indispensable for metabolism. Second one is some plant polysaccharides are only partially utilized for energy. As dietary fiber, they affect in different ways various processes in gastrointestinal tract or GI tract. So function of food, first one is that source of energy, help in metabolism, as well as element and compound indispensable for metabolism. Next one is the distribution of lipid in food raw material depend on their role in living animal and plant organism. Next one, in an animal body, lipid occur primarily as an energy rich store of neutral fat in subcutaneous adipose tissue as kidney, leaf and crotch fat. As the intramuscular fat known as marbling and as intramuscular or seam fat. So this line is very important that in an animal body, lipid occur as an energy rich store of neutral fat in adipose tissue. So this is very important. Some minor component can be useless or harmful if present in excessive amount. Remember, when present in excessive amount, like most food raw material are infected with different microorganisms and often pathogenic, and some contain parasite and the product of microbial metabolism. And if these microorganism, parasite, pathogenic, bacteria, microorganism, they are present in food, they can convert raw material into contaminated material. And a number of compounds are added intentionally, like antioxidant, colorant, flavoring, sweetener, and if they are present in excessive amount, they can be harmful. So next one is, first food component is carbohydrate. So carbohydrate are widely distributed in plant and animal tissue. Carbohydrate commonly occur in food are starch, glucose, fructose, sucrose and lactose. These are most commonly occurring carbohydrate. Energy value in average diet is provided by carbohydrate and it is the cheapest source of energy. Glucose derived by digestion of carbohydrate is stored as glycogen. So glucose stored as glycogen in liver in case of animal and muscle tissue and used as the main source of energy in the body. Hence food must always contain adequate amount of carbohydrate. And the source of carbohydrate are cereals, maize, root, tuber, pulses, sugar, jaggery, milk and sugar. Next one is the nutritional value or carbohydrate content of some important food. So it's a very important chart. First one is cereals like rice, jawar. They consist 63 to 79% carbohydrate gram per 100 gram. So this is a chart where name of the food and how much amount of carbohydrate present in that food. So please take a look at this chart also. Pulses like gram, red gram consist of 56 to 60 gram per 100 gram. Next one is the protein. Protein content in food is present mainly as crude protein. And the nitrogen to protein conversion factor and ratio P, nitrogen to protein conversion factor of 6.25 has been recommended for most plant and animal food product under the assumption that nitrogen content in the protein is 16%. Nitrogen content in the protein in various food, however, is different because it depends on the amino acid component of protein compound. Because when you see the structure of amino acid that consists of a carboxylic group and amino group, so such as free peptide and amino acid, nucleic acid and their non-protein nitrogen may constitute up to 30% of total nitrogen. So protein component also present in the food. And these are source of protein like eggs, jerky, cheese, yogurt, bean, lentils, unopened tofu, frozen edamame. And protein content of different group of food like cereals and mild consist of 6.14%, pulses 18 to 24%, oilseed and nuts except coconut 18 to 40%, meat, fish and liver 18 to 20%. So these are nutritional value and the how much protein content present in different food groups. So it's also a very important chart. Next one is lipid, a group of naturally occurring substances characterized by their insolubility in water and solubility in organic solvent. They occur in plant and animal tissue. Lipid can be in simple lipid form, in compound lipid and derived lipid. Oil and fat serve as the main source of energy. They also provide the essential fatty acid. They are good source of fat soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins like A, D, E, K, and fat serve as an insulating material in the subcutaneous tissue. And these material for the synthesis of cholesterol and certain hormones. Hormones like steroid hormones like progesterone, estrogen, thyroxine, retinoid, they are mainly. Lipoprotein and glycoprotein are essential for maintaining cellular integrity. Protein plus lipid is lipoprotein, glucose plus protein are glycoprotein. Fat is essential for maintaining good health. It's a fat content of different group of food. So it's also a very important chart. Next one is the mineral. Minerals are naturally occurring inorganic element in the soil, which is transformed into an organic compound for use and assimilation by the human body. There are 16 minerals that the human body need in order to function properly. And these minerals we can get from where? Fruit and vegetables. And milk products supply the majority of calcium and phosphorus in the diet. Calcium is mainly responsible for bone health and phosphorus is mainly responsible for maintaining acid-base balance in our body. Acid-base balance and calcium for bone health and proper functioning of nervous system. Affecting food composition. First one is the raw material. The content of different component in food raw material depend on the species and variety of animal or plant crop, age of the farm, harvesting of the plant, age of farm animal, and post harvest change that take place in crop during storage. Second one is the food industry by establishing quality requirement for raw material. Third one is the content of desirable minor component can also be effectively controlled. Next one is the processed food. Processed food means conversion of raw material into finished or semi-finished product. That is mainly food processing. So composition of processed food depend on the recipe applied and on change taking place due to processing and storage. Change occurring in food due to processing. First one is leaching of soluble, desirable and undesirable components such as vitamin, mineral and toxin during washing, blanching and cooking. So these changes can occur. Dripping after thawing or due to cooking, loss of moisture due to evaporation. During food processing, moisture can lost, and sublimation absorption of desirable or harmful compound during salting, pickling, frying and smoking. So what we have discussed today, we discussed food component, food component and food component that they supply in the human body and their role in bodybuilding and energy yielding and compound indispensable. And in detail we discuss about food component like carbohydrate, protein, fat, dietary fiber, calcium, iodine, phosphorus and the composition that present how and the composition of that particular component is present in different food sources and their nutritional value. So So thank you so much, everyone. If you find this video beneficial for you, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel for more such kind of videos. And if you have any query regarding this lecture, you can comment down below. Thank you so much.